Merry Christmas, one and all. Yes, the time has come.
Filthy animals.
You've eaten your turkey. I was going to say you've stuffed your turkey, but that could be taken the wrong way. You've eaten it.
You've given your family COVID.
Yeah, you've spread your COVID. You've kissed your nan. You've Frenchied your nan. The damage is done. But we're here to...
You've racked up more kills than the Yorkshire Ripper at this point.
R.I.P.
You Netflix documentary out.
We're here to announce our premier award. The Cunt of the Year 2020. Joined by Seddon, Mideon and Midge, as I have been throughout the last week. So thank you, boys, one and all, for joining me. Each and every day.
I would just like to say we have the band ready to play you off when you receive your award. Okay, just
thanks. I came prepared with a speech, to be honest.
It's a good job you can take a joke, Jesus.
So we're going to run down our singular choices. We may have some honourable mentions. I think I certainly do. Let's. Let's kick things off. Who's going to win the award this year? Well, for me, I ummed and ahed over this category. I've gone through various different entries on the spreadsheet we've compiled. I won't announce yet who I chose. I'll announce why I haven't chose certain things. I think that's probably the way I'll go. I was going to choose the guy who berated me at the local NCP, to be honest, because I was struggling to get out the barrier.
I liked that one. I wish you'd come with that one.
He was a right cunt.
I want to hear the story. Go tell. Well,
okay, I just finished a hard slog at work. Yes, they do happen. And I'd parked at the local NCP, but I'd gone in and taken a ticket, but once in the office, I then found I didn't have my wallet, so I wasn't able to pay. I wasn't able to pay, basically. So when I came up to the barrier, I thought, well, I'll just, press the buzzer and phone some dude on the helpline. And I was getting no success with that idiot. He was kind of just telling me to phone someone with my card and get them to text me the number and blah, 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 which, to be fair, is exactly what I did. But, that's not... I just wanted him to open the barrier, to be honest, and just let me out. Otherwise known as stealing, to be honest.
You're stealing right to their face.
Do a Mr. Bean stuff, where you wait for somebody to come in the entrance and then you just like ram their car out of the way and go through the entrance.
That would have been quite good, I think. But as I was at the barrier having this conversation, there was quite the line backed up behind me. And you see it in the TV show. Someone just came up to my window and just gave a little tap on the... tapped my driver's side window, and he asked me how long I was going to be, and he asked me to back up so the others could get through. And I ain't gonna lie, I told him to fuck off. I wound my window back up. I did what he said because I didn't want to get into a fight, but I was enraged. I was absolutely enraged. But he probably had a point, to be fair. The trouble was, the other barrier wasn't working, so nobody could leave that NCP because I was having this conversation. But anyway.
Be fair, are you nominating yourself as cunt of the year? Because this story, it literally is, you blocked every poor fucker wanting to go home after a day's work in a car park because you left your wallet at home. That's what I'm...
Yeah. It's like that Mitchell and Webb sketch where they're Nazis and they say to themselves, are we the bad guys?
Yes.
Am I the bad guy in this story? I guess I probably am. Shit.
I love that. Are we the bad guys?
But anyway, it's not him. And it's not COVID, because, I looked at COVID and yes, it has been shit, but it has brought us some bright moments as well. We came back and podcasted because of COVID. I speak to you boys every Friday night. Fuck it, it's COVID. No, it's not. but yeah, some goodness has come out of COVID. So I couldn't pick it. I could not pick it as my kind of the year. The person I could pick was Donald Trump, and that's who I've gone with. Donald J. Trump, no longer president of the United States of America following the US elections. But my God, is he not going quietly? He's going like, I would describe it like Benjamin, as if he didn't have a biscuit, wasn't allowed to have, a bag of crisps before his dinner. He just won't have it.
I think of it as like you leaving a multi-story car park.
Yeah, very good, very good. But yeah, you know, I think he is the biggest arsehole on the planet. And for me, at one time, he was the most powerful man on the planet. And that was a very dangerous thing. But he's gone now. So, yeah, fuck you, Donald Trump. You are my cunt of the year. Let's go with Midge.
All right. It's a difficult choice, really. I mean, we've mentioned, obviously, how much of a knob COVID was. But, yeah, I decided to, again, cheat a little bit. I've gone with not one, not two, not three recipients for this award.
If you're saying 11 and you're going to call out the Liverpool football team, I'll love you forever.
But more, well, they're included in this number.
Yes.
But more nearly enough, 70 million people will be receiving this award. So my vote goes for the British public.
Ooh.
Throughout this whole COVID pandemic. My day job is working in retail. And the absolute morons and mouth breathers that live in this wonderful country just can't seem to follow simple little rules and instead decide to just do whatever they want and be the most selfish buggers on the planet. So you know what? Fuck you, British public. You win this award. I hate you, and I'm so glad we're being forced to stay inside so I don't have to see you. But please watch my movie.
You know what? I've just realised, why the hell do you work in a public-facing job?
Because at the moment, that's all you can really get.
That's probably true, yeah.
And to be fair as well, like people have said in the past, why haven't I left? I've been in this particular job for almost 12 years now. It's mainly because I'm very fortunate that I can live off of a part-time wage. It is a part-time job. I work 4 days a week. Meaning that I can focus all of my other free time to doing what I actually want to do. Mm. Whereas if I had changed jobs, my free time in order to reach my goals in life would have been severely restricted. So as much as I hate it, in a way it has been a way of doing what I want to do, but I'm just not quite at that level yet. But that still doesn't stop me from hating the public. But yeah, every single day that, you know, the days I am at work, I lose count of how many times I have to tell people to stay 2 meters away from me, take a step back. Aren't you wearing your mask properly? It's ridiculous. People are stupid.
Oh dear.
There need to be more people like this lot.
Yeah, they do. They do. I feel for you. I really do. The British public, if you are listening, then please just wise up.
Come less cunty, will you?
Do us a favour.
Thank you, Midge. Seddon, before you do your one, I will just say that the cunt of the year could be a person, moment, or subject that made you scream cunt in 2020. So I think that's important to stipulate before you go with your pick. So over to you.
I want to do a quick honourable mention, Stu, for yours, Trump. Trump was very, very forefront in my mind when I was considering this, because I don't think you can have a sentence and use that word without him crossing your mind, because he is horrific. However, I think this is weirdly one of his lesser horrific years, and don't get me wrong, I think he's been devastating to the health and the well-being of the American population, but probably no more devastating than he has in the other year. And mine is probably actually the same as Midge's, but it was a particular example of the British public. And I think there was, when you're looking for silver linings in this year, I think there were some moments in lockdown one where you saw people kind of come together and get a bit of a community spirit. You know, we were all locked down together. We were all locked down to, for the good of all. And of course there were rule breakers in that, but I think en masse, there was a lot of compliance there, and compliance for good reason. But one of the things that I thought was amazing was, because all of us were in our houses, you started to see like birds in the trees again that you hadn't seen for ages. And you know, like on the news, there would be stuff about wildlife. And I even started to think about like the lack of cars that were on the road, we were probably making a big difference. We probably had less of a carbon footprint. Then, 3.5 minutes after we were allowed out of the house, a load of cunts went to Bournemouth Beach. And not only did a load of cunts go to Bournemouth Beach, but probably other beaches, and broke all rules by being close and sat there and said, well, what do you all fucking want? It's a warm day, isn't it? I've been in my house for a month. That was bad enough. But then they left and you saw the amazing amount of rubbish they just left. And it was just devastating to watch. And, you know, this goes to other things like where you would look at, I don't know, some countryside walks and people who take photos and families had gone back out there and they'd done what in effect looked like, gone down the supermarket, bought everything they could and just threw it on the fucking floor and went home. And it just reminded me how gross and disgusting and selfish a lot of human beings are. So come to the year is anyone who took 5.5 seconds to go, I'm going to break the rules. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fuck up all the good work that probably 2 months that nature had without us parasitic scumbags draining on it. To us is my answer.
To us.
To us.
Here, here.
Mid, what have you got?
So my picks could have been obviously the public. Like I've already said, Donald Trump was high as an honourable mention. But I think the person that got to me the most is probably going to be my pick is the Wetherspoons founder, Tim Martin.
Oh, yeah.
Good absolutely great fucking show. Cunt, mate. you know, when the pubs closed, the first lockdown, literally wouldn't pay his staff, just told him to go work at Tesco. I don't think you could be any more of a cunt than that, mate, to your staff, to be honest. This dude's just a complete dickhead, and on his interviews on like Sky and that at the time, he was like, yeah, I don't think there's really any transmission in pubs and all this kind of stuff. Like he's some fucking Dr. Fauci leading scientist or something. This guy's just a dickhead, man.
Can barely pull one of his own pints, but yeah, suddenly he's a medical expert.
Yeah, and if you've ever seen a picture of him, just looking at his face will just wind you up because it just looks like it's...
Oh, that's a good pick. Good pick. Now, do we want to do something a little bit different here? Do we want to come up with a collective? We've got our four nominations. Do we want to just announce one?
Well,
ultimate cunt of the year. I don't know.
I think the fact that every choice that we've had has been a part of the human race. Why not just go the human race? You know what I mean?
Yeah, we are. We are just a scourge on this planet, aren't we?
Something Stu said about like not picking COVID as such because of some of the positives that are there and things like that. And I almost want to say the same for the human race, because I do think there are some great people out there, and I really do, but it's really hard to see them for all the other pricks in it. So can we go with, like, if we're going to do a conglomerate, could we not go with like 75% of the human race?
Okay.
I don't want to damn us all, because there are some all right people.
Yeah, 75% is a good number. I like the number 75. Yeah. So yeah, let's go with that.
Okay, we'll go with that. 75% of the human race, you are our official Renaissance Men cunt of 2020. Well done.
Give yourself a round of applause. Pat yourself on the back and hug the person next to you. Hug the person next door to you.
Yeah, 2 meters away. I've had a great time doing this. Midge, I know you've got to run, so thank you for joining us. Go enjoy your Christmas day. It's been a pleasure to speak to you.
Thank you, everyone. Have a great Christmas and stay safe.
Yeah, I just want to say, good luck for 2021. I hope obviously you tick more things off the bucket list.
Thank you.
Filmmaking wise. And we will be speaking to you on tomorrow on a Boxing Day special quiz that you've got for us.
Yes, indeed I do. Get your quiz brains ready and be ready to sit in the mastermind chair. Don't worry, it will be sanitized between each round.
Will it have your sex towel over it like it usually does?
I don't have that anymore.
Oh.
It's gone.
R.I.P.
End of an era. Have a good one, guys.
Cheers, catch mate. Yeah, thank you. DRB will be joining us for the quiz as well, hopefully. Bless him. I don't think he's watched or seen or done much this year for various hopefully reasons.
It's no general knowledge, isn't it?
Yeah.
Or anything about TV shows or films, I think. I think we've all got specialist categories, though, so I don't know what he's picked, but hopefully he's picked something that he knows something about. So
I think he's gone Formula One. So
he'll be good at that. Yeah. I'm actually quite worried about it. I've got nerves about that. I've been fine. We did a video podcast. I come on podcasting, but...
You can't lose to Stu. It's easy. Don't worry about it.
That's the thing I'm so worried about. Just like, you know, like general knowledge is the thing I'm more worried about, because I'm going to go, they're going to ask me a question that's really fucking easy, and I'm just going to dumbass it. And yeah,
you'll just crumble. Yep,
yeah.
Crumble. So yeah, we've got that planned tomorrow. We hope you have enjoyed your Christmas, and we hope you've enjoyed the 2020 Stiffies. I personally have had a great time doing it and compiling these lists. Hopefully if we're still alive, we'll do it next year. But yeah, thank you for joining us. We'll be taking a break now until, like I say, after the quiz, we'll probably take a break till the new year. So we'll probably come back on that the first Friday of the new year, whenever that is, I don't know, 7th or something. So yeah, thank you for joining us. Glad to be back, to be honest. It's been a strange year. We've decided to start podcasting again, and it's been fun. So, thank you to everyone who's kind of supported the show. You know, thank you to the boys who've come on every week and shared their time with me. Yeah, that's really all I've got to say. So, yeah, here's to 2021, I guess. Let's hope it's a lot better. But, take care. We'll speak soon. And goodbye.
Sleep in heaven.